You wanna get nuts? Let's get nuts.
I'll do my absolute best to guide you so we can get that smile of yours back to normal.
Thank you.
Funny reference to the previous story that we've seen. What? Fukiburai? What the? That's all right. Really? I think it has, wow, I think it has actually different purpose of your existence, it existence. Fuck me, what?
My phone's been updated again. So the last soul fragment is in this part of the cage, huh?
It appears so.
Which brings our little road trip to an end. Kind of brings a tear to your eye.
Yeah. Real sad.
Which means
you're not even pretending to be sad.
Are clouds?
Scarecrow. Time to go to work. Restore the past recorded inside, and you'll get your fragment.
This Scarecrow looks familiar. Tonight, I weave for you the tale of a kingdom wreathed by sea and sand. The heroine of our story is a charming princess who seeks true love for herself. Ruling over both sea and desert, this kingdom thrives in trade. And its queen has issued a notice. My beautiful princess no longer smiles. Any man who returns her joy may have her. The men in the courtyard queue in place, waiting to claim the princess for themselves. The first hopeful begins to speak. But his words do not reach her. She does not smile. Men's words are hollow things. They tell the princess they see her only for her station.
Next.
But that error is not theirs alone. Indeed, all who live in the kingdom are blind. They cannot see the princess for who she truly is. With her face a stone, the men surrender and return to their homes. No one understands me, she sighs. But then, a lone boy dressed as a sailor appears before her. One barely on the cusp of manhood. He makes no mark on her, for today she has seen more strange men than there are stars in the sky. The boy begins to spin a tale of wild adventure. He speaks of a djinn he met on a journey. He speaks of desert islands filled with wonders. Of seas so vast, their edges have never been found. The princess is enraptured by his tale. She stares at him from behind her veil, saying not a word. On the queen's signal, the boy is escorted away. His voice grows distant, and silence soon returns to the palace. As the princess ponders this development, another uninvited guest comes to see her.
Parsultan? Parsultan? Do you speak Parsultan?
You should leave before I change my mind.
How annoying. Well, gotta admit, it's running smoothly so far.
A fine effort.
No, really. No shitty business.
I anticipate improved circumstances.
Yeah, me too. Hell, it's happening to me.
The dark of night falls over the palace as the princess rushes through its halls. The fantastical palace in which she lives is in truth a prison that has stolen her freedoms. The words she uses, the way she acts, even the order in which she eats her food. Every aspect of her life had been decided from the day of her birth. No one has ever seen the true me. None of the men, and not even that boy. Day after day, she plays the role of a demure princess. Unable to bear this curse, she eventually lost the will to smile. The bedroom is adorned with the most elegant and fanciful decorations. It is one of the few places she can find peace. At a signal from her lady-in-waiting, the princess changes her clothes. The moon once again emerges from behind the clouds.
Damn, what?
She stares at herself in the mirror, dressed now in the guise of a fortune teller. It is a persona she assumes only when the sun takes its leave from the sky.
What in the world? Are you not kidding me? Oh, fuck me. Fucking cruelty. This woman is representing
She orders her lady in waiting to keep watch, then slips from the palace without a sound.
The fucking I've got nothing to say.
She will be greeted by the bustle of a city bathed in danger and vice. And it is there that she will slip the pent-up frustrations of her carefully orchestrated life. Huh?
Oh, good job there, kiddo.
You got a phone action. Wow. I wonder who he chat text to.
I knew this scarecrow looked familiar. It's the princess from the last past I visited. Say, what were you doing on your phone?
Just playing one of those mobile games.
You play while I work. Cool.
God damn. Let's check what's there. Once per day, right. Here we go. Yeah. Nice. Fuck this. Bathe. Okay, so well, there was wow. Vanya. So and Yuri. Okay. Sing. Type 40, what? Thank you.
fade again. Fuck. Fucking blood. $27,000. Wow.
Nice.
That's perfect.
What?
Twice, wow. Thank you. Shit. Additionally paid from real money. For real fucking wooden pieces. Okay, which one? This one. I'd like to see her button that when you push her and she will enhance by itself. You no need to worry about and pressing, tapping, clicking and do what kind of things like that. Just push one button and here we go. If you got resource, money, You're good to go. That's it. But how it is now is kind of disaster. Fuck? Why? Why? Yo. What a force has been. Hold on. Fuck you. Fuck you. No, fuck you. No, fuck you. No, fuck you. Fuck you. No, fuck you. Fuck you, no, fuck you. Fuck you, no, fuck you. Fuck you. No, fuck you. Fuck you, no, fuck you. Fuck you, no, fuck you. That's the I'm talking about. The power. Power. Or attack. What's the better? Power or attack? When I switch. When will I swap them both? I will lose the force, but I will gain the attack. Ah, fuck it. I'll leave it. I'll just. By the way, weapons. I've read about. I definitely have a mastery. What is it? Okay, well, let's continue. Bang! Fuck. The force reduced, but why? Come on, what? Well, that's kind of Junker stuff. I don't know why, but it's been reduced. So why? Motherfucker, why are you doing this? Yo, motherfucker. I need to enhance him, I guess. I guess. Oh, you didn't see. It's okay, I guess. Finally begin.
I'll cut down everything in my way. Come.
How's that feel?
Sucks.
Continuing mission.
I have anticipated improved circumstances.
Too slow.
And we're going right.
There's not much room to walk here.
Only one way to go. Straight to them.
Was that an earthquake?
Try not to look down, all right?
Please don't say things that'll make me want to look. You should leave before I change my mind.
Continuing mission.
She's nuts. I'm the man of her. Just one move and that's it. Enemy is dead. Wow, just wow. She capable to down the entire wave by her own.
We just saw had such a fancy room. Canopy bed, too. I've always wanted to sleep in one of those.
You ever wish you could be a princess, Hina?
Oh, you know, maybe a little. Although, I'd be happy to just have a normal life with my family.
Happiness comes in many forms, and that sounds like one of them to me.
Yeah. Okay, so the floor gave way, and then... Wait, where's Papa? Guess I have to keep going.
Try to call him. Papa.
Hina? You okay, girl? You hurt?
Yeah. Not sure how, but I'm fine.
Phew. That's a load off of old Papa's mind. Well, don't worry. I'll guide you over the phone until we meet up.
All right. Scarecrow.
Great! Then go to work. You're fine on your own, yeah?
Yeah, I think so. Every night, the princess slips out of the palace for her own amusement. She sits in a dim and dingy alleyway, one that lies forgotten by the people of the city. This small tent is the princess's second home. It is a place where she tells fortunes, one of her own creation. Yet her divinations often ring true, and rumors claim her words can change fate itself. She waves her hands over a crystal ball for her first couple of the night. Even as a child, the princess possessed a gift for fortunes. She sees the couple's fate in the crystal ball and prepares to speak it aloud. The light within the ball grows faint and vanishes.
Tear the couple apart. Damn.
With an exaggerated inflection, she speaks. Your man is unfaithful. He spends his free nights prowling the city for new partners. Betrayed, the woman rushes away in tears. The princess's divinations often tear seemingly happy couples apart. Whenever this occurs, she feels her melancholy ease. When she assumes the guise of the fortune teller, none realize she is the princess. This only confirms her suspicion that no one sees her for who she truly is. Not a soul within the palace, nor a soul without. Another vision flickers to life in her crystal. She sees strangers peering into her world. The princess quickly recovers from the unexpected occurrence and informs the couple of the result. It is a dangerous game to toy with the heart of another.
I'll cut down everything in my way. Come.
Continuing mission.
I've got enough death for everyone.
A fine effort.
But be it as fortune teller or princess, the woman knows salvation will never come for her. Alas, her life proceeds on a path that is set by another. As the princess sits deep in thought, a familiar boy passes before her tent. It is the sailor, the selfsame one who came to the palace spinning tales of adventure. Perhaps he sees the real me. She decides to test his motives. She forecasts his grim end with these words: death awaits if you continue to see the princess. But then... the boy bursts into loud, innocent laughter. She watches him as he vanishes into the thick of the crowd. I wonder if he will come to the palace tomorrow, she thinks to herself. As she slowly makes her way home, she finds her steps to be lighter than usual. That should do it.
Seems like you finished the job. Now keep on going.
Dead end.
Such unfortunate. Let's go back in.
I'll cut down everything in my way.
Come. How annoying.
I've got enough death for everyone. I'll cut down everything in my way.
Continuing mission.
Got enough death for everyone.
A fine effort.
Bird statue?
a tap. See what's what.
It warped me.
Well, don't that beat all? I can't see your coordinates on the map anymore.
What?
Oh, never mind me. Just keep on trucking.
What map? What kind of coordinates? What the hell? No!
The flowers are glowing. It's really pretty here, but also kinda lonely.
And cross here too, right?
Beautiful. What kind of flowers are these?
Miniatures.
Is this my brother's notebook? It's the one he used in elementary school. He was always writing stuff down, like ideas for pranks. A door over there.
Maybe you can get out of there. Let me take a look.
But I don't want to get out of here.
Oh wow, this is Dad's mug. My brother and I saved up to buy this for him.
Man, this picture. Still here. And that exact place.
I wonder if someone used to live here.
Correct. Get them bastards. They know how to make me cry.
What's my hair clip doing here? My brother laughed and told me it looked terrible, so I never wore it.
It was highly extremely unexpected. God damn lunatic.
This door won't open.
Well, that's strange. The only only way forward. Well, this ain't good. Except some putting up.
Hello? You there?
Oh, fifth. Just stay for Hina.
Oh no. What should I do?
Take some time here. Spare a little bit.
Hope nobody minds if I rest here for a bit. Guess I'll have a seat. Been a while since things have been this quiet for me. It's so quiet. You okay, Hina? I hear someone calling me and open my eyes. Guess I fell asleep at some point. I rub my eyes and look around. I'm at my grandparents' house, the place I spent all my summer vacations. The living room had a beautiful view of the garden, as well as a grand piano. I used to love playing it. Whenever I'd finish a piece, the whole family would compliment me. They said my playing was incredible. Those moments were the only time I could make my family smile. The only time I could truly bring them together. Though I was young, I felt proud to have such a power. It's now a memory I keep locked deep inside my heart. Later, much later, my family changed. Mom got reckless with her spending. When her debts finally came to light, Dad started to crack under the pressure. Dad used to be so serene, but now he yelled all the time. And Mom started to get new bruises. I couldn't accept how things had changed, so I just ignored it. But I kept a smile on my face, even as I was unable to stop my family from falling apart. My days were a long, dark tunnel with no end, and all I could do was keep walking forward. And though I prayed for help, I knew my pleas would go unanswered.
Hina? Wake up, Hina.
Guess I fell asleep.
Look who's finally up.
Papa? How did you...
My love for you led me straight here. Might have bruised myself breaking through some walls, though. Also, it's my job to get you home. Okay, kiddo?
Thanks.
Looky there! Do my eyes deceive me? Or is that a key? You think it'll open the door in the back?
How do you can come? There's no hole in the wall.
Great! Now we can blow this popsicle stand. Were you sad without old Pop around?
Nope.
No.
Actually,
I
was.
Wouldn't
but
say
not
that.
Because of me.
Finally, at the third scarecrow.
Number four.
The light of the sun gently illuminates the princess as it awakens from slumber. Though she warned the sailor boy of his fate, continues to come see her. She knows he will be back again today. Day after day, he flashes a daring grin as he fabricates tales of adventure. He wants so badly to see her smile. And at some point, she finds herself taken with him. The boy appeared before her like a bird that rules over the free skies. Perhaps she can flee her kingdom prison with him, and only him. She arrives in the palace courtyard. The sailor boy greets her with a confident grin. She stares at him from behind her veil. She can feel him looking at her. Not her riches, not her status, her. Yet though she so desperately wants to believe his heart to be true, she cannot shake her doubts. After a moment of thought, she decides to test him. She walks toward him. In a faint voice, no louder than a whisper, she graces him with a plea. Elated, he leaves the palace, thinking to have finally obtained the princess's heart for himself. But she knows the truth. When they next meet, it will be clear if he truly sees her or not. Alas, there is a demon whose sharp eyes see through the princess's intentions.
Hustle. Pure mass.
Dust.
I'll cut down everything in my way. I've got enough death for everyone. Princess and fortune teller stand together in her room. The princess has come up with a plan to test the sailor boy. Will he see the rich clothes of her lady-in-waiting and assume she is his prize? In her guise as fortune teller, she can only pray he makes the right decision. Concealing herself, she waits. At last, the sailor comes to the princess's room. As the scene unfolds, her heart sinks in her chest.
sailor does not recognize the lady in waiting in disguise and quickly spirits her away. The sailor boy is just another grain of sand in an uncaring desert. And short-lived as it was, the princess curses herself for permitting her heart to feel joy.
Kidding. What the hell she expected? How the hell he gonna recognize her if she wearing a bit fade or it's kind of mask before he's wearing her face? She didn't see her face. How the hell is she supposed to recognize her? Anatomically, they're both similar. On the dama in the white and dama in the fortune teller. What the fuck? What the fuck is wrong with her? Where is your brain, Sayid, at last? Okay, woman moment.
The one person she most wanted to see her wasn't even looking at her.
But you would notice if someone else showed up in my outfit, wouldn't you?
I don't know.
Unique case. Really unique case. Something. Such a ridiculous moment. What in the world happened right now? Why is she fucking thinking that way?